There's definitely something in this town. Do you feel it, Zach? My coffee warned me about it.
Yesterday morning, the milk I poured in my coffee made a sign. It said, "Tomorrow you'll arrive in a place that will change your fate."
Now you were very late. I didn't think you'd keep me waiting in the rain for so long.
FBI Special Agent, Francis York Morgan. Please, just call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Agent York?
Good, that's good. Are you the sheriff?
No, I'm Deputy Sheriff Emily Wyatt. George, he's the sheriff. He went looking for you, actually. He should be back soon.
I see.
If you don't mind me asking, did you walk all the way here?
My car broke down, that's all. She's easy on the eyes. Definitely worth a trip to the primitive world.
By the way, don't mention anything about what happened back there. She'll think you're a psycho. Don't want that, do we, Zach?
Welcome to Greenvale. I'm the sheriff, George Woodman. Call me George.
FBI Special Agent Francis York Morgan. Please, just call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Could you tell me why the FBI is so interested in a small-town homicide?
Let's just say it's a personal interest in killers of young women. I'm always looking for new sample cases to help me with my profiling.
Both our superiors have cleared this with each other. You can remain in command. You don't have a problem with this, do you?
No. No problem. Just want to set things straight. Our small town has its share of problems. I'm the one fixing them one by one and maintaining peace and order. You can have your profiling sample, but I need you to understand that.
Of course. By the way, George, I had a little accident with my car. Could you send someone to take care of it? Oh, and my clothes and luggage are still inside.
All right. Don't worry. I'll get my assistant, Thomas, to take care of it. Do you need anything else?
Thanks. That'll be all. Well then, I think I'll rest up first at the hotel. Then I'll join you on your investigation.
Don't know how to say that. We really don't need your help. Unlike some of your corrupt city police officers, I play it by the book. I hope you'll come to appreciate that, Agent Morgan. And we'll handle the investigation. You just think of this as a vacation. Take it easy. Enjoy the nature here. You don't have to be a tree worshiper to appreciate the wildlife here.
Zach, let's reassess the situation. There are no cavemen here. We're as far forward as the Middle Ages. And we've just met the king. Previously during the investigation.
These puppies are making me go to another town in the boondocks again.
I didn't think you'd keep me waiting in the rain for so long.
Welcome to Greenwood. I'm the sheriff, George Woodman. Call me George.
There's definitely something in this town. Do you feel it, Zach? My coffee warned me about it.
It's broken. I've been using that one for a long time.
Why didn't you get it repaired? This TV is important to you, right?
It's got some memories attached to it, sure. I used to watch movies on this thing with your grandma all the time.
Grandma liked movies?
Of course she did. Everyone loves movies, right?
I love movies, too. I've never been to a movie theater, though.
Don't breathe. Hold your breath. They can't see you if you hold your breath. Hurry. Like this. Cover your mouth. Cover your mouth.
Who are you?
Zack, the symbolism in my dreams continues to intensify. A forest of red trees, a carpet with red leaves, a strange doll, and twin angels.
But that child is what bothers me the most. I swear I've seen him before. I just can't remember where. Well, it'll probably come back to me eventually. For now, we need coffee.
Let's head to the cafeteria, Zack. I hope they have some real coffee. I really need some coffee. Then we can head to the sheriff's office. There's a proper procedure for everything, right, Zack?
Thank you.